to Zoom into church with Gid and Han. We're in a new we're in a location we've been before, but we're in a new place within that. I'll give you a second to work out where we are. We've got some funky animals behind us. Of course, we are in the children's room at Crag.
I've got lions and tigers.
That's really cool.
And I've got the entrance to the ark.
I've got a penguin. He says he's lost. And an octopus.
I mean, a penguin would definitely be lost. What looks like very nice weather. And then there's Jeff. I don't know if you can see, but there's Jeff. It's never funny.
Welcome. This is our last week, actually, at Zoom into Church for 3 weeks. We're going on holiday to our homes, but we're going to have 3 weeks off, and then we'll be back with you guys, hopefully, in September.
Wow. We hope we'll be meeting in person, but I highly doubt that. We'll probably be back in September.
We'll just have to wait and see. So this is us.
We will.
Do you want to introduce today's challenge, which I'm really excited about?
Yeah, you're going to win it. As you can see on our tables, we've got our, let's call them swans. They're kind of swans. Hannah is so delicately showing. What we're going to be doing is, actually, this was recommended by the Ship Please. Woo-hoo. We saw them last weekend, but they recommended it over the email, so thank you very much for that. They recommended it because they said it was a task that Hannah could win. Now, it's craft, so I'm going to be terrible, but I've had a little bit of practice, as you can see. Yeah, and Hannah has found the instructions for it, as well as done a few herself, maybe a few more than me, but I'll give her the benefit of the doubt. Anyway, so we're going to have 2 minutes to do as many as we can.
Come on.
Now, I'm expecting to only get about one, because there's a stage in them that we both stumble at, and it's not very easy, is it?
No.
And, it could be interesting. Hannah's hoping for two,
yeah,
I think, which is probably fair. You never know. When it comes to the time, I might speed up, Hannah might slow down, so it could get very interesting.
And so if we're both at the point where we've both made one and the time is up, then it'll be whoever is the closest to finishing
their second one. By the way, they do have to look like swans. I can't just like scrunch ball paper and be like, yeah, I did it. So
I thought that was a given.
It's not with me, because if that was an option, I would cheat.
Are we ready?
I am. Let's wait till the time is. Don't start folding, little.
I'm not starting. I'm just excited.
Right. 3, 2, 1, go.
This cake is hard to fold.
Yeah, it's not very nice. Fold.
There we go. Are you on the head yet?
Just on the
head. No. Yes! First time.
Did you?
Yeah, man.
Well, that's you winning.
First one done.
Okay. That tells you where this game is going. I can't finish the heads. Oh, there we go. I've done it now.
Well done. Well done.
Why not having it? Oh, no, I've done it the wrong way around.
How are we doing on time?
You've got like 50 seconds.
Have I got 50 seconds?
Yeah.
Come on. Remember about the where the wings go. I love that I'm like, I'm beating you and I'm trying to help you.
Yeah.
I would not be doing this if it was the other way around.
I mean, I've done it, but the head's broken.
I'm a little beefy.
Have you completed
made it the second one.
Aha!
Yeah.
Now, how long have we got?
You've got like 10 seconds.
Oh, let's see how.
I mean, you won.
Woohoo! Oh, well, man. Am I done? We're done. Are we done?
Yeah, we're done. I've done 1.5, so yes. I think you won. Well done, Hannah. You did very, very well and very proud.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, what's that in the scores?
Do you know what? I'm super proud because I've managed to keep you off from getting 10 before I got to 2. So it is now
9-2.
Hey,
you never know. Coming September, you might be closing in. I've now got to sit for 3 weeks stewing, knowing that I lost. And hey, Anna might come back and win.
This is going to give me the confidence I need.
Peter, can you give us 7 weeks so that it gives Hannah a chance to get back and win? Let's not go to church for the next 10 weeks because we're having 3 weeks off. We want to go back as soon as possible, but we're making the best. Right.
How wonderful.
How wonderful. I've now just got... I'm just going to take these two off just so that they're out of the way.
Look how beautiful this is.
Oh, you've made a nice little seat.
I've got a little mummy and lots of little babies. It's wonderful. So our verse of the week, this week, is one of my favourite verses in the whole Bible. It's a verse that is really dear to us as a South Africa team. We often are called the Micah team. So some of you will be going, oh yeah, I know what it is now. So it's Micah 6. Oh, it's also linked with... Anyway, it's just a good verse. It's just a really good verse. It's Micah 6, verse 8. Mm. And we were struggling to find it earlier, weren't we? It's
in a way, it's right at the end of the Old Testament.
Yeah, so it's one of our minor prophets. So it's right near the end, just before Matthew, but not quite the last book.
It's in those books where there's like 2 pages per book, so you kind of get a bit lost very easily.
So it's Micah 6, verse 8. Are we ready for our Bible race?
We are indeed.
Ready, Marks? Get set. Go! I've gone too far.
Got it.
No!
Oh, I haven't won a Bible race in a few weeks.
Yeah, to be fair, like, I often win those.
You do often win the Bible race.
I am there.
You are there. So, Micah 6 verse 8 says... He has showed you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God.
Come on.
That's a great verse. And later on in the service, we're going to be hearing Scott is doing the sermon.
Come on, Scott!
I don't know how we did that. And Scott's going to be talking about race. Now, that's a really interesting topic, and it's a topic that people often shy away from talking about because it's a really tough topic. Mm. But it shouldn't have to be tough. It should be a topic that we're all pretty well-knowledged on, anyway. So, what we have is, in the world, we have people of all different skin colours, all different shapes and sizes. You have people who are large. I was a lot larger than I am now. And then you have people who are skinny. You have people who are tall. You have people who are short. You also have people, as I said earlier, with different skin colours. And in the verse here, it says to act justly. Now, justly is a big word because we're using adult Bibles. But justly essentially means to treat people fairly, to treat people how you want to be treated, and to treat people the way they deserve to be treated. Mm. And a great example of this is Jesus. Jesus treated everyone, no matter whether they were rich, poor, whether they were black, white, whether they were anything in terms of shape and size, Jesus treated them all the same. Whether they had jobs that people didn't like, whether they had jobs that people did like, he treated them all the same. And that's the important thing to take, is no matter what a person looks like, no matter how they dress or anything, you treat them fairly. And we also shouldn't make presumptions. So you can quite often, by just looking at someone, make a presumption, which means judge them before you know them. And that's not a good thing to do. You need to give everyone an opportunity and treat them nicely. Is that, I think that sums it up reasonably well.
I think you've done a sterling job.
Lovely, lovely.
So that is our topic for this week. Our craft this week is the same as our challenge. Whoa!
That's what happens when you do a crafting the challenge.
So I'm going to send you the same link to the instructions that we've done, so you can maybe do these at the same time as us. Mm. But we'll also send you some other funky animals, because there's so many animals that you can make. I just chose these because they were easy and simple.
I didn't find them simple, you did. But hey.
But if you've got any craft that you want to show us, if you make any of these, if you make any other animals or any other crafts from other weeks, please do send it in to interns@cbcl.org.uk.
She missed it last week and she got pulled up on it by a couple of people. So,
it's back.
She had to go extra today. I also will just mention again what I mentioned last week when we were in the cafe. It opens on the August the 18th.
So oh, yeah.
Kids, best your parents to go. I'm sure, Tracy, you'd be very grateful to see all your lovely faces turning up.
Maybe not all at the same time.
Not all at the same time. They're spreading into the sanctuary in various areas and key outside if you wanted to. So it shouldn't be... It'll be safe, don't worry. Tracy has it figured out. She's great at that sort of thing. So, why don't we have a little prayer? Would you like to pray?
I'd love to pray.
Go on then.
Heavenly Father, I thank you that you are our Daddy God. Father, thank you that you created each and every one of us in your own image. Father, thank you that that means that we are all equal in your eyes. Father, help us to see one another in the way that you see us. And help us to see Jesus as our example. In Jesus' name. Amen! Awesome, guys. Well, we hope you have a wonderful, wonderful summer. And we will be back in a few weeks.
We'll miss you.
We'll miss you.
We're sure you won't miss us. Yeah, we'll see you in September, guys.
Right.